And welcome back to the Northeast Florida Surf Fishing Forecast. This is for July 31st through to August 2nd. Before we get started, the last few days, the water cleaned up. We had a thunderstorm come through on Tuesday in this area, and it set here all night, and the wind completely died at the beach, and the water cleaned up, and it's been clean ever since. Light west winds, and there's been some nice whiting caught. Tons and tons of little 7 and 8 inch pompano. The palometas have actually been bigger than the pompano, which is not usually the case. And the trout have shown back up in the surf, top water, and live shrimp sitting in the sloughs first thing in the morning or right before dark. Plenty of tarpon, especially in Ponte Vedra and the Volano area. Many of them are actually within casting distance from the beach, so if you got the rod for it, give it a shot. But yeah, it's been good. There's been quite a few sharks as well. The people who have been shark fishing at night have been landing some pretty decent sharks. I saw a picture the other night of about an 8-foot bull shark someone caught. That's a feisty guy. You don't want to tangle with him out in the water. But anyways, let's get to the forecast. Tomorrow, July 31st, you got winds west 5 to 10, switching over to the southeast at 10 to 15 through 2 to 3-foot surf. In the tides, you got a high tide at 5:56 a.m. in the morning, a low midday 12:07, and then high 6:43 p.m. in the evening. August 1st, east at 10, increasing east-southeast 15 to 20, surf 3 to 4 foot. You got a high tide at 6:53 a.m., a low at 1:03 p.m., and another high at 7:36 p.m. Sunday, the fun day with our tropical system that should be right off our coast at that time. Northeast 20 with higher gusts, possibly up to 40. 5 to 8 foot surf is what they're calling. It could be bigger or it could be smaller depending on what this storm does. You got a high tide at 7:46 a.m., a low at 1:55 p.m., and then a high at 8:25 p.m. So if you're gonna fish, it really looks like Friday is gonna be your best bet, and early Saturday until that wind really picks up. They're calling for 15 to 20 in the afternoon, but of course, if that storm speeds up, it's gonna be a lot stronger than that. And if you haven't done it, go ahead and get you some of Chip the Sinker Man Sputniks. They will hold in this rough weather. And if you decide to fish on Sunday, let us know if you have to use a Sputniks, how they hold up in that big surf. The fish will still feed. It's just a matter of being able to hold. The fish bites have been the bait of choice the last few days. The clam, sand fillet, and shrimp flavor are catching the whiting, the pompano, and the palometas. And the sharks will hit cut bait and whatnot. The water's clean now, but it's going to probably get dirty. I would say by Sunday, that water's going to be nice and churning. So it's not going to be good. We got a nice few days of clean water, so it's all we can ask for sometimes this time of year. You know, as we get into the summer months, those tropical systems pop up real fast. And if you can't hit the surf, but you still want to fish, hit the river, guys. The flounder bite is fantastic. Mullet, mud minnows, live shrimp, jig heads with live shrimp, and pretty much any artificial lure you like to throw, they are eating them up. Just keep it moving. Still, the first 3 hours of incoming have been best for me. That's what I've been catching them on. That doesn't mean that's the only tide, but that's what I've been getting them on. The low tide has been dead for me, so I've been fishing the high only, the first 3 hours of the high. So guys, give it a shot. Look for structure and fish around that in little eddies, places where the flounder can sit out of the current and ambush their prey. Also, reds and trout are hitting the same bait, so there is plenty of fish in the river with all the bait. There are tons of shrimp. I was catching tons of shrimp this past few days throwing for mullet. So the bait's there, guys. Go get them. Let us see some pictures. Also, I was able to talk to the one of the crane operators at the pier. They're still aiming to try to get it done on time. It's a little iffy. As you can see, they've already added a couple more sections just this week. The main problem is getting people who want to work. It's amazing. Unemployment as high as it is and people don't want to work. So, hey, if one of you guys knows how to help build a pier, give them a call. They could definitely use you, and us fishermen would greatly appreciate it. As you can see, too, they're adding fence along the piling. So in shallow, you will not even be able to throw up under the pier. If you do, you'll be catching a chain link fence, and I don't think they're very good to eat. So, yeah, we'll see. As they get out further, I don't think they'll add the fence. So that's just more pilings for us guys to fish when the tide is low enough to reach it and when they're not working. And it's pretty cool. They'll be able to back the trucks all the way up on this standalone structure. So, also, plenty of sand fleas, guys. Plenty. I counted about 10 to 12 schools in about a 50-yard span. As a wave goes out, they're just bubbling up. Not sure that everything's eating them right now. Sometimes in the summer, they don't work so great. But if it were me, I would get some, and it never hurts to throw one on, especially around structure or around the rocks, Volano rocks, Nassau rocks. You got Fort Clinch. Those sheephead are still here. A lot of people just stop fishing for them this time of year because they think summertime is not the time for sheephead. Also, guys, Andrew has some delicious looking smoked flounder. Here's the recipe. You have got to try it. There's even a video of him showing it off. I'm going to have to barter to get some of this. It looks delicious. I saw it the other day and my mouth just started watering, guys. Look at that. Looks great. I don't condemn, I don't convert. This is the calling, have you heard? He's also an excellent rod builder. And I've added his Facebook page for his rod building. He would definitely be a guy to talk to if you need a new rod built. He builds beautiful rods here in the Northeast Florida area. So if you're in this area and you want a new rod built, hit him up on Facebook and I think he can help you out. Looks delicious. I'm getting hungry just watching this video. And here's his Facebook page, guys. Landico Custom Rods. Great rod builder. Perfect rods. Also, if you haven't yet, join our Facebook page. We're almost to 600 members now. Lots of useful and helpful information. And don't forget to check out Surfline for the beaches in your area. These go up and down the east and west coast. And for your tides, don't forget Tides for Fishing app or tidesforfishing.com to check the tides for your specific locations. All right, everyone have a great weekend and tight lines.